भारत देश सन 1947 को ब्रिटिश हुकूमत के चंगुल से आज़ाद हुआ। देश की आज़ादी के बाद एक लोकतंत्र की स्थापना हुई थी। आज समय आ गया है कि हम शिक्षा को भी डेमोक्रेटाइज करें।
द नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया इज ट्रूली बिल्ट ऑफ द पीपल बाय द पीपल एंड फॉर द पीपल। इट इज आवर नॉलेज लेगेसी टू फ्यूचर जनरेशंस।
ई उद्यमान्नी देश नलुमूलला व्यापिंपजेसि ప్రజలకు మంచి నాణ్యమైన చదువు అందించాలనే ఉద్దేశంతో నేషనల్ డిజిటల్ లైబ్రరీ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా ఏర్పడింది।
छोटे बच्चे हैं जो पूरी प्रिविलेज नहीं ले पाते सी बुक्स दी या जर्नल्स दी कुछ अच्छा मटेरियल जिस तो वांझे रह जाते सी उन्हें बहुत अच्छे तरीके नाल मिल सकता है।
इंटरनेट और सहायत मोबाइल टेक्नोलॉजी और कंप्यूटर यूज करी भारत सकलो शिक्षार्थी सकलो ठाइर पा नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया यूज करिब पारे।
शिक्षण पद्धति है, व्यवहारिक ज्ञान है, थीसिस है, डिसर्टेशंस है।
नांगल इंद देसीय लाइसेंस पयनपड़ुत्तुवदनाल नूलकत्तिन उल्लडक्कत्तै एल्लोरुम इलवसमाग नाडु तळुवि पयनपड़ुत्तलाम।
आमादेर नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी एमन एकटा प्लैटफर्म जा आमादेर सभ्यता संस्कृति एवं शिक्षार सम्पत्तिके बाकिये राखते साहाज्य करबे।
The true success of a library lies with its users. Hence, I invite all of India to make use of this platform.
I am National Digital Library of India.
I am in National Digital Library of India.
I am the National Digital Library of India.
Main National Digital Library of India.
Moi National Digital Library of India.
Nenu National Digital Library of India.
Hu chu National Digital Library of India.
Naan India vin. देशीय नूलगम
मी निरुपमा बावड़ेकर नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया आहे।
आई एम नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया।
मैं नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया।
आमी नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया।
वी आर नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया।
Okay, so that's a quick video about NDLA. So yes, Dr. Meena Rani in the group, the librarian. Okay, Dr. Meena Rani is here. So I will just unmute your mic. Just give me a moment. It's getting yeah, it's on.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, yeah. Welcome for the session.
Thank you. So now it's 11:36 in my system. So should we start?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So maybe you want to give a brief introduction and then we will move ahead, or should I start?
Sir, you brief about your information. So I did not collect your biodata, first of all.
It's fine.
So, fine. Perfect. Can you share your details? Yes.
Yeah. So just give me a moment. So I will mute your mic, or you can mute your mic by yourself, and then whenever there is a requirement, you can turn it on. Is that okay?
Okay, sir.
Dr. Meena Rani, kindly mute your mic. Okay, fine, done. So good morning, everyone. My name is Dr. Vignesh. I am from the National Digital Library of India team.
I look after the outreach of the National Digital Library of India. Before we get into the session, I just wanted to take you through a small background of why NDLI and what is the purpose of NDLI. So, and then we will move on to the presentation. So, in 2014 and 15, when the government of India was looking at the various higher educational institutions' budget for libraries, it was almost the same amount of budget, say anywhere between it, especially for the centrally sponsored institutions like IITs, IIMs. The budget was for the libraries were around 20 crore to 25 crore rupees of budget. And they were all procuring the same amount of resources from the same, almost same publisher with some minor modifications here and there. So the then HRD minister requested all the IITs and IIMs to see if we can actually collate all these knowledge resources which are available openly in the public domain, to collate all these resources and then put it for public use for the entire country. So that was the call given by the then HRD minister. And IIT Kharagpur was very quick in responding to that call. So IIT Kharagpur, led by Professor Partham Pratim Chakrabarty and Professor Partham Pratim Das, these two gentlemen came together and then they conceived this idea of National Digital Library of India. So the idea of NDLI, National Digital Library, reason being one, first is like I will talk about from my personal experience. So I studied at one of those prestigious institutions where the library is okay, there is some, just give me a minute. I think there is some disturbance in my audio. Is it so? Am I clear? Is my audio clear or should we disconnect and reconnect? Can you put it in the chat? Okay, for some of them it seems to be okay, for some of them it seems to be some issue. Let me just check the audio volume. Is it okay? Is it fine now? Okay, good. So, fine. Thank you for the feedback. So now we will move ahead in the presentation. So what I was telling is like, I studied at one of those institutions where the library is 24/7 open. You can access the, you name any major resources, it's there. You have closer to few lakh resources. And there I found three or four major challenges. First and foremost is like most of the foreign author books or foreign printed books, it will run into few dollars or few pounds. And these resources, most likely when it comes to the library, it will be issued to a faculty member. The faculty member gets it issued for himself or herself. And the one good part is like they keep renewing it for a few times without any questions asked. And as students, we wait for the faculty members to return the books. So we wait for a few weeks. And then what we have to do is we go to the faculty and then we get it photocopied, take permission, and then we get it photocopied from the faculty, and then we return the book back to the faculty member. Or a student takes it and then he keeps renewing it for at least 2-3 times. So there is So even if they have a few copies, two or three copies of the same resource, the access to the resource is very limited. Maybe one or two person can at a max can access that resource. So that is one limitation that we saw in the physical library. And the second limitation is, so you go to the library, the resource might be there in the library. You go to that section and then you search for the entire section, except that one resource, rest of the resources might be there. So because one brilliant student in the campus will hide it somewhere so that nobody else reads that resource. So that's the second kind of things that happen. And the third thing that happens is, it may be there. Okay, I think there is some network issue. Just give me a few minutes. Let me just check the network issue and then I will be back. Is the audio better? I will turn off my video. So we will have only audio from my side and some we will share the screen. There seems to be some network. I tried at least three networks. All of them are having the same bandwidth. It seems there is some network issue here. Okay, so it's better. So may I request all of you to kindly turn off your video. Stop the video. Thank you. So the third issue I was mentioning is like about the resource may be there in the library and you go to the so-and-so section and you will find the resource in that section, but except a particular chapter, rest of the book might be there. So some student might have turned off those pages, those specific chapters, or they might have underlined it with some pencil or pen so that it becomes unreadable for others. So this is what happens in the library, in the physical library. And the next thing is, in the last few years, the budget for libraries has drastically come down, be it any major institute, public or private institution. The budget for library has come down to 1/5 or 1/10, even in some cases. So what it results is like the access to knowledge resources will actually in turn lead to better educational outcomes. So when you stop giving access to good quality knowledge resources from your library, the actual learning outcomes and the educational outcomes will drastically go down. So that is what has been the lessons we have learned. So the Government of India started this National Digital Library of India with an objective to take educational resources, quality knowledge educational resources to everyone, every Indian citizens, so that they are not deprived of learning materials. So with that objective, NDLI was started in the year 2016 as a pilot program. And today we have closer to 4.78 crore resources ranging from various domains. So now I will start the presentation with the PPT. Is the presentation visible? If yes, kindly put a visible note on the chat. Okay, so now I will start the presentation. So the objective of this session is why NDLI, which we have already seen, and who is this for, what kind of content we have at NDLI, how to access NDLI, what is the difference between Google and NDLI, and how to operate NDLI Club in your own institution. This is what you are going to see it in this session. Okay, so the country's today's need is the young generation needs quality knowledge resource for anyone, anytime, and anywhere. So access to knowledge should be for everyone. So that is the primary objective of NDLI. So the perspective of NDLI is so you look at the NDLI map, the India map, except very few states, Kerala, Goa, Tripura, and Mizoram. The rest of the states, the literacy level is like below 75%. And also there is another statistics which says every year, every month, at least 10 lakh people turning into 18 years of age. That means India needs to address the higher educational requirement. So they may get into colleges or UG and PG. So India needs at least 6 universities and 270 colleges every month to bridge the educational divide. Okay. So, but addressing this through physical infrastructure will become an unsustainable proposition. So the government of India looked at having alternative technology-enabled solutions like Swayam, Swayam Prabha, NPTEL, and NDLI as alternative learning and complementary resource materials. So NDLI was formally dedicated to the nation on the 19th of June 2018 by the then MHRD minister. Now let us see who is this for and what kind of content we have at NDLI. So NDLI is meant for everyone, starting from the school going students to the college going youths, professionals, academicians or researchers, edupreneurs, and lifelong learners. It's for everyone who is interested in learning. And we basically collaborate with content contributors. Say, for example, we have collaborated with all the major educational and research institutions in the country and also outside of the country. So far, we have collaborated with around 251 such content contributors. So some of them are listed here, and there are many more such partners. So let's look at what type of content we have at NDLI. So computer science, information and general works, we have closer to 99 lakh resources. Philosophy and psychology, 5.3 lakhs. Religion, 2 lakhs. Social sciences, 45 lakhs. Language, 1 lakh. Natural sciences and mathematics, 83 lakhs. Technology, 1 crore. Arts, fine and decorative arts, 4.5 lakhs. Literature and rhetoric, 7.8 lakhs. And then history is 6 lakhs. So this is the kind of resources we have at NDLI. So these are the top 20 content contributors, World eBook Library, and ultimately the government of India has procured national license from World eBook Library so that you can have full text access from World eBook Library. CiteCRX, PubMed Central, IEEE. So these are some of the content contributors. And then what kind of content we have at NDLI? We have a range of contents. So maybe a ebook, article, video lectures, audio lectures, term papers, assignments, question banks, assessments, data sets, manuscripts, thesis, dissertations, law judgments, law acts. So you have a range of contents at NDLI. So now let's look at what are those major kind of learning resource type we have. Article dominates the list with 2.95 crore resources of the total resource, and then followed by books, which are 63 lakhs, reports 12 lakhs, notes 11 lakhs, law acts 8.7 lakhs, law judgment 8.7 lakhs, technical report 7 lakhs, thesis 6 lakhs, historical record 5 lakhs, video lecture 3 lakhs. And then access options. So as I mentioned, so far we have closer to 4.79 crore resources, out of which, so if we have 75% of the resources as full text resources. So how do you identify these full text resources? There are two icons. One is the green color lock opened icon. Another one, a rectangle box with National Digital Library of India written on this box. These two denotes that these resources are full text resources. So so open resources are around 2.72 crore resources. And then NDLI resources are 77 lakh resources. So we have 3.6 crore resources or full text resources. Full text resources means you can actually download these resources and use them for educational purposes. So that is the meaning of full text resources. Now let us see how to access NDLI. So you may, if you are comfortable, you can also use your mobile phone right now as I speak to check whether you are able to access NDLI or not. So accessing NDLI is very simple. Go to Google, type National Digital Library of India or any other browser for that matter, Firefox or Safari, whatever browser you have. And then the first URL that appears is ndl.iitkgp.ac.in, or alternatively we have another URL called ndl.gov.in. So what you need to do is you just click on this URL. Once you click, it will take you to the home page. So this is how our home page looks like. So during this time of Corona, our team has further classified the content into various educational levels and educational streams. Okay, so I will talk about it in a little while. So now let us see how to access the content. So on the top, you have the search bar. So you just put the search keyword. So here I have put the first search keyword as history of English literature. Okay. And then I clicked on search icon. And then I applied two filters. On the left hand side, we have around some 10 filters. On the right hand side, we have one content type filter. Okay. So here I have clicked subject category filter. And then I applied language and literature and rhetoric. So I got 6.74 lakh resources on history of English literature. And then I searched for a term called financial accounting. Okay. Here I applied two filters. On the left hand side, I applied for a filter called access restriction. I clicked on open and NDLI. On the right hand side, on the content type filter, I wanted only video lectures on financial accounting. So I clicked on video. I got 1727 video lectures on financial accounting alone. And the next search topic I searched was business economics. Okay. Here I have applied two filters. One is access restriction, which where I have clicked open and NDLI. Another one is subject category, which is social science and technology. So I got 6 lakh resources on business economics alone. And the next topic I searched was entrepreneurship. Here I wanted only open and NDLI resources. Then I got 28,725 resources on entrepreneurship alone. And suppose if you want to further narrow down only for video lectures or only presentation, you can click on these icons also. And then the next topic I searched was on cost accounting. Here I clicked, I wanted resources only for levels of UG and PG appropriate content. And then video lectures only. So I got 1,822 video lectures, which are appropriate only to UG and PG, undergraduation and post-graduation. And the next topic I searched was on microeconomics. Here I wanted resources only from Asim Premji Foundation and MIT Open Courseware. So I got 251 results on microeconomics. And the next topic I searched was on financial management. Here I wanted to know only how many theses are available on financial management topic. So what I did was I searched for the term called financial management. And then I applied a filter called source. Here I typed InfliBNet Shodganga. Okay, so I chose InfliBNet Shodganga. Shodganga is the collection or repository of all the thesis, PhD thesis submitted in the country. And InfliBNet Shodgangotri, Shodgangotri is the dissertations which are submitted at the level of MPhil. So this is the collection of, suppose if you want only thesis, InfliBNet Shodganga, you just have to click on InfliBNet Shodganga, you will get all the thesis available on financial management. Here there are about 15,000 thesis available on financial management. And the next topic I searched was on business analytics. Okay, so I wanted from the source of NPTEL only. That is only video lectures are conducted by the NPTEL faculty members. So I got 506 video lectures on business analytics. So as I mentioned, in this time of Corona, our team has further classified the content into various educational disciplines and streams, educational levels and streams. So here, suppose if you want to access the content, what you need to do is click on this Corona outbreak study from home icon. So it may be blinking. So you just have to click. Once you click, this pop-up window will appear. So here you can see how many educational levels and educational dreams are there. So school related content, UG engineering related content, UG science, UG other disciplines, language, management and law. Okay. So you can accordingly choose the level of content and the discipline and the level of content, and then you can actually use the content. And the next topic I searched was on sales and marketing management. Let's see how to download a resource from NDLI. I searched for a topic called sales and marketing management. So suppose if I want to open the first resource, which is coming here, I just have to click here. Once I click, this will take me to this page. Okay, here I have already logged in. Here my name is appearing, Vignesh Swarnamohan, and there are two tabs on the top. The first tab is called content and the second tab is called metadata. What you have to do is first click on the metadata and check where the resource is from. What is this resource all about? Metadata is nothing but basic information about a resource, which is, say for example here, salesmanship and sales management. This is the topic of the resource. Who is the author? John George Jones. He's the author. Where is the source coming from? World eBook Library. So this is the basic information about that resource. And you check the access restriction. So here it is written NDLI. So when it's open and NDLI, you can actually download the resource and use it for educational purposes. So see, if you find this resource useful, what you need to do is just click on this content. Once you click, the entire resource, so there are about 385 pages of material available on this topic. You can download this resource and use it for educational purposes. Suppose if, so in the earlier slide as I showed, when I logged in, I can actually download. When I have not logged in, here I have not logged in. So when you click on the content tab, this message will appear. Okay, so here you need to click, please log in to view this content. Suppose if you are already registered, click on this login to view this content. So suppose if you have already registered, just put your email ID and password and then enter the CAPTCHA and then click login, you will be logged in. Suppose if you have not registered, okay, or say for example, you have never registered at NDLI, what you have to do is click on this register button, then it will open a small registration form. Okay. And then you just have to click on that registration form, fill the registration form with some basic details like your full name, your email ID, personal email ID, password and confirm password, and some basic information about you like what is the gender, date of birth and all, and then submit. Once you submit, you will get a verification link. Just click on that link and then you are all set to go. Suppose you are already registered, but you forgot your password. Then what you have to do is click on this account recovery icon. So once you click on this account recovery icon, it will ask you for your registered email ID. Then you just put your registered email ID. Then you will get a link for resetting your password and then you are all set to go. Suppose if you want to open a video lecture, so this is how the video lecture will look like. Okay, so using NDLI is very simple. First, you need to get into the home page and then search the topic. So you have to type the topic, the search topic, very clearly without any spelling mistake. Suppose if you make any spelling mistake, the results will vary. And then the filter options. You need to know the filter option to narrow down the results. So here I'm going to talk about some important filters. One is access restriction. The first filter, which is like, suppose if you want only full text, what you need to do is click on open and NDLI, then you will get the full text resources only. And the second filter is author. You give a keyword and then you look for the author which you are given to you. You say search here and then you will find the author relevant here. And the third filter is subject category. You have to understand which subject category your topic comes under and then choose the subject category. And the fourth thing is learning resource type. Suppose if you want an audio book, just click here. Suppose if you want a video lecture, go here and then type video. Then you will get the video lecture. Suppose if you want a newspaper article about it, just click on the newspaper. This is the learning resource type. And the fifth filter is source. So I told you there are about 251 content contributors at NDLI. So you just look for the appropriate content contributor and then you're good to go. And the sixth filter is right hand side, the filter which is available is content type. So you just choose the relevant content type and then you can use. Apart from this, there are other filters like file format, language. You can further filter it using file format and language filter also. So I've already mentioned about the access options, the green lock open and the rectangle box National Digital Library of India written. These two denotes the full text options. So you can actually use the NDLI entire interface website using various Indian languages like Hindi, Bangla, Gujarati, Kannada, Marathi, Oriya and Tamil. So in these languages you can use the NDLI interface. Also for the young generation, we have created apps, mobile apps for both Android as well as iOS. So you go to your Play Store or iStore and then you can download the NDLI mobile app. Now let us see how to use the NDLI mobile app using the Android version. So this is how the, so you download it, go to Play Store and then download the NDLI mobile app. And once you open, this is how the Android mobile app looks like. So this is the home page. Suppose if you want to search, what you need to do is click on this search icon, then this search box will appear. Okay, here you type the search keyword and then click enter from the keypad, then the results will come. So here the results will come and disappear. So there are about 41,573 results on Uttar Pradesh. Suppose if I want to filter it down, so here the filter option is available on the bottom right corner. So this orange color icon is the filter icon in the mobile app. Once you click, all the filters which we saw on the desktop application will appear on the top. So you have to basically scroll the filter. So here I wanted the source filter from Aligarh Muslim University. So I clicked on source and then I chose Aligarh Muslim University and then clicked on apply. I got 299 results on the topic of Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so now I'm going to give you a small activity. Okay, I'm going to give you 5 minutes of time. Now it's 12:06 in my system. So I'm going to give you 5 minutes time. All of you kindly go to Google Play Store and download NDLI mobile app. Install it in your mobile app. Suppose if you are using an iPhone, go to iStore and then download National Digital Library of India app. And then search for the keywords, topics which are in your subject domain and which is of interest to you. So kindly do a search and see whether these resources are, whether this NDLI is useful for you or not. So already I think Yudhishthira OPR has already done the registration. So now I want you to quickly search for the topics, subject topics which are relevant to you and then give me the feedback. So I'm going to give you 5 minutes to one, download the app and then do a search of the topics which are relevant to you. So 5 minutes and your time starts now. We will resume the session by 12:11. All of you kindly be here, okay? And then I will just mute my mic and I will be available here itself. Fine, start. Once you are done, just put a chat message that you have downloaded and whether it is useful or not useful to you. Okay, so I think people have started searching also. Sachin Bhatwaj, Bhupendra Singh, Diksha, Johnny Basketball, Dishasa. So Dell, so all these people have downloaded and they have searched also. So kindly, we have 1 more minute left. So kindly search the app and search the subject and then give me your feedback. Dushant. Stronger or okay. Mansi Jain has conducted and Abhishek Kumar, Lata, Devi Shri. Muskan. Purva. Shashank, Akshay, Anil, okay, so very good. So now we will restart the session, we restart the presentation. So thank you for the feedback. So now I want you to, after the session, I want you to share this app with your colleagues, with your fellow students, with your friends and your relatives. So we are about 36 people now in the session. So even if you spread it to 100 people, we can reach at least 3,600 people through you. So I request all of you to kindly spread the message of NDLI to your friends and relatives so that everybody gets benefited from this app and you don't have to pay a single penny for using, downloading or using this app. Okay. So now we will start the presentation again. So kindly let me know whether the screen is visible to all of you. Okay, so I think the screen is visible to you. Now I will start the session. Thank you, Balami, for the feedback. So, like today what we do is for any topic, for any information that you want, we go to Google for looking for the information, right? It's good. It's a very great tool that we all use in the day-to-day life for accessing information on the World Wide Web. But there is a slight difference between Google and NDLI in terms of educational purposes only. So now let us see the few slight differences between NDLI and Google through a small demonstration. Say, imagine there is a girl called Payal who is studying in class 8 and she wants to learn about magnetism in the subject of physics. Another guy called Shamik, he did his M.Tech and he wants to pursue his PhD in the topic of magnetism. So what they have done is both of them went to Google and then they searched for the term called magnetism. So they got 2.49 crore results on the term of on the search topic of magnetism. And they both came to NDLI and then they searched for the same term called magnetism and both of them got the same results of 4.19 lakh results. So now what Payal did is she applied two filters, educational level and language, and she got 56 results. Whereas Shamik, he wanted only career and technical paper, so he got 290 results. So now you can imagine where is 2.49 crore and where is 219 results. So now how, let's see what is the major difference. So first and foremost difference is, Google is a brilliant tool. We don't have any competition with Google. Google does its job brilliantly. Okay. But what Google does is it searches for the term. Say, for example, we have given the term called magnetism. It will go and search the entire World Wide Web. And wherever this term magnetism is there, it will pull out the results and then bring it to you. That means if Google can't distinguish whether that resource is coming from an authentic source or an unauthentic source, whether it's relevant for educational purposes, whether it's relevant for the user or not, it can't distinguish. It will fetch the data as it is available in the World Wide Web. Okay. Whereas at NDLI, all our resources are coming from the partners. Those are the partners who are in the educational domain. They know their subject better and they have contributed these data. And then we have curated these resources and then put it into our system. And the second difference is in Google, you can't filter the content. Whereas at NDLI, you can narrow down the results using the filters. And the most important last is NDLI has procured national licenses, which means some of the contents, for example, the South Asia archives and the World eBook Library resources have been procured. The government of India has procured national license, which means these resources can be used by the Indian citizens at free of cost. So these are the major differences between Google and NDLI. And what is the big picture? Already there is a option for credit transfer and virtual certification. So there is an option for accumulating 20 credits from MOOCs, from Swayam, Swayamprabha and NPTEL and then transfer it to your regular coursework. So that is already possible. And what will happen maybe after 5 years or 10 years, and today due to Corona, it's already happening. The learning can happen completely online. So that is the possibility which may come up. So now let us see how to operate NDLA Club. So the purpose of NDLA Club is to, primary objective is to promote the culture of reading. So today, many students or many, in general, the citizens' reading level has drastically come down. And to promote the culture of reading, NDLA and the Government of India has promoted this idea of NDLA Club to promote this culture of reading and promote the knowledge resources of NDLA also. So how do we do it? And from each class, at least one student, and from each department, one faculty member. And librarian as the ex officio secretary and principal as the ex officio chairman of the club. And this list has to be approved by the head of the institution. And then there is an NDLA Club registration form that is available. So you just have to apply the apply for the NDLA Club registration, and then your account will be, we will give you a certificate of registration that is valid for 1 year. And within 30 days of getting the certificate of registration, your institution has to register all the students and faculty members through the NDLA Club members by obtaining three information. One is the personal email ID, their first name, and the last name. They have to collect all these three details from all the students and faculty members and then send it to our email ID, which is ndl-support@iitkjp.ac.in, with a copy to my email ID, which is vignesh@ndl.gov.in, or my personal email ID, which is vigneshjnu@gmail.com. So they have to send it to us. And then we will do a bulk registration of all the users that they have to activate their account. So this is the first step that they have to do. And the individuals can also register on their own. So how they do it, go to NDLA homepage. On the bottom right corner, they can see the register button. Once they click the register button, this registration form opens. Okay. They have to fill the full name, email address, password, and confirm password. These are the mandatory details. Once you fill the mandatory details, you can go and submit the form. You will get a verification email, and then you can activate your account. Okay. So after the first month, so we are expecting the institutions to conduct at least 10 reading or knowledge related activities over the next 12 months. So what are those activities that can be conducted? A lecture series, or a quiz competition, or a storytelling session, or a go fish session, or a film screening, or a drawing competition, or a role play, or a writing competition, or a make a speech, or a debate competition. And these are all just indicative. You can also come up with any reading or knowledge related activity in your own institution. And then you have to submit a activity report every month so that we can track the activities of NDLA Club. And then if you conduct based on the reports, we will do an evaluation, and then we will further renew your clubs, NDLA Club registration certificate. And these are some of the images of the activities being conducted by NDLA clubs in the country. So we also have designed some incentive mechanisms for NDLA clubs, best performing NDLA clubs at the district, state, and national level. And also we have come up with the NDLA Reading Olympiad also. So these things have already started rolling out. So this is what I wanted to share it with all of you. And I'm happy to respond to your questions. So if you have any questions, kindly put it on the chat window, and then I will respond one by one. Okay. So now it's time for question and answer session. Any questions? Yes, Dr. Miramani, you have some questions.
Sir, can you please explain once again the institutional membership and individual membership? I have a little confusion in that.
Okay. So,
go back to that slide.
No, I will explain it briefly here, and then we can have a discussion over phone separately on this. So what the difference between individual registration and bulk registration is, so when UGC or NAC or AICT comes for visit, and that time they ask for the digital resources that you are subscribed to. So suppose if you are registered with the NDLI and if you have an NDLI club also, then you will get the 2 points or 3 points which is earmarked for this purpose. And that is that will happen only when you are registered as an NDLI club on the institutional or bulk registration. But whereas if they are registered in individual capacity, they may not be counted under your category. So that is the difference between individual and bulk registration.
Okay.
And for more,
we have already taken institutional membership of NDLI. And our faculties and students also are registered. Every year, the freshers, while conducting orientation, we used to register their names. You said the year-end, some awards or points, you said, I didn't get
points. That is for NDLI clubs. So what we can do is we can have a separate conversation on the NDLI club separately. Okay, so students, if you have any questions, students or faculty members, if you have any questions, I'm happy to respond to your questions. Kindly put it on the chat window. That would be easier to respond. Yes, there is a question from Gauri Shankari. Sir, do we have access to e-books like novels? Yes, we have some of the best top 10 novels available at NDLI. So you can read fiction and non-fiction resources from NDLI also. So kindly give a search on the topic of relevant to you, and then you can get the resources which are, say for example, I searched for something called 1984, which is a top 10 novel in the world. And the entire full text is available at NDLI. So that's written by George Orwell. And that entire full text, you can download and use it. That's a good question, Gauri. Any question? Any further questions?
Sir, what about research articles?
Yeah, we have a lot. We have a lot. So you can search. Okay. So, Dr. Miramani, what I have seen best working is in some of the institutions, what they have done is they give assignments every month to students on the topics that the resources should be taken. They give a topic and the resources should be taken from NDLI. So, that mandatory things they have given. So, then the students have actually started using it extensively for their travel.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah. Gauri Shankari, Harry Potter we may not have. So Harry Potter series we may not have. Okay, if there are not much questions, shall we wind the session?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir, for the wonderful session you have shared, and we have learned a lot of things, and it was very informative and elaborative. I hope our students, faculties, and professional colleagues have benefited from the session. Thank you so much. So we are planning to host one more session for especially for faculty members, those who are taking research work and those who are pursuing their PhD. So I think I'll contact you after May 3rd.
Sure. Yes, Dr. Miramani. So thank you everyone for your kind patience and listening to me. And there is one final question from Mitunjay. can we access books for CSE preparation, civil service examination. So currently our one more vertical is coming up for competitive examination alone. So there you will be able to access all the competitive related materials. Currently we have IIT JEE materials and we will have more resources. Sauravi, yes, there is another question from Sauravi, like management accounting. Yes, we have. So I would like to thank all of you once again, and I wanted to repeat my request to all of you. Kindly, after this session, kindly share the NDLI mobile app with at least 100 members in your class or from your family or from your friends group, so that we take these resources across the country. So once again, I thank all of you for your kind listening and kind participation. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Bye. Thank all the participants, staff, and professional colleagues. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye.